what I really love about the work of Hizmet as a Muslim, and I've got to know them over the years, I live in Seattle right now, I'm from Bangladesh, is that this particular group does not just talk about the message of the Quran. You know, I and some others, we rattle off beautiful verses of the Quran and the many, many exquisitely beautiful, timeless, precious messages from the Quran. But the people in Hizmet, they're actually living it, not just preaching it. For example, the Quran says that if Allah wanted, Allah could have made all of us one single community. But Allah chose to create diversity in everything, including religions, so that you might come to know the other. And I've seen so many programs of Hizmet doing extraordinary work in reaching out to people of different religions to really practice what the Quran says on a personal level, on a human level, to connect with the other. What we call in South Asia, practice three cups of tea. Listen, respect, connect. The other point I would say is that, you know, the Quran, the most used word is Allah, 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 Allah. But the second most used word is ilm, knowledge. And I love the emphasis that Hizmet puts on education. Not only in schools, which is remarkable, but really in raising people's awareness, in becoming a more expansive human being, to open up the heart. You know, the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the ink of the scholar is more holy than the blood of the martyr. So this emphasis, this focus on awareness, on education, on knowledge, on wisdom that is practiced by Hizmet is very close to my heart. Thank you.
I think the charitable activities of the Hizmet movement is one of their strongest points. I was very impressed the first time I visited Kim Siyak Moo and the relief organization in Istanbul.
They go to the toughest places. It's not just Haiti, where there are no Muslims for the most part. But it's also other parts of the world as well, including parts of the world where there are no other charities because of war or because of terrorism or because of any kind of violent conflict that other organizations are afraid to get into, like in Somalia and parts of Iraq.
That's also active wherever need exists. And it seems to me this is the highest articulation or expression of the religious religious experience and of religious truth. That is to serve not with words, but with deeds, and to do what we can to alleviate unnecessary suffering around the globe.
There's so much suffering in the world, and people can't afford to get nursing care, they can't afford to have their teeth fixed, they can't afford to get medical care, and these Hizmet charitable organizations are filling the gap and helping so many people, especially in places where they're war-torn and there's horrible things going on. Who would do this to help people if not Hizmet organizations?
Doctors going to prisons and taking care of prisoners there. Food and supplies going to all these other parts of the world simply because those individuals have been motivated to do that themselves and because of the instructions and the motivation that Fethullah Gulen has given them to be a part of humanity and to serve mankind.
It's a movement that is seeing a problem and saying, okay, well, we see a problem, now how do we address that? I don't see any sense of, well, now what can we get from that? How is this good for us? But, you know, we're supposed to be helping people. How do we do that? And I just see there's a freedom about that I like, and an unself-consciousness that I like.
So when Hizmet goes into disaster zone, whether they're in Muslim-majority countries or in countries where Muslims are not in the majority, and they serve people the same way, that is a reflection of one of the highest ideals of Islam, that you embrace other human beings.
I'm sorry if I appear emotional, but that sense of selflessness, that sense that you have to give in order to achieve in the hereafter, and doing it as part of a team which is working together, that is phenomenally distinctive of the Hizmet movement. So my du'as and prayers remain with them, and I pray and hope that these concepts of service, of excellence in all that we do, and of giving selflessly, they become truly a part of the Muslim identity, and institutions and organizations across the world adopt it, so that this becomes a part of social betterment.
So I welcome the activity of agencies such as Kimse Yakmu around the globe on behalf of those who are in need.
I would describe Fethullah Gulen as a very holy person, a spiritual leader, a beloved and revered teacher, a faithful and devout and pious Muslim, and most of all, a servant leader. I use Fethullah Gulen and Said Nursi in a class I teach on the ethic of service at Duke, and I love lifting him up as a modern example of a life lived in faithful service that is deeply rooted in the principles of the Islamic tradition. Gulen is a good example of how a life of service isn't always glorified. I think through a lot of faith-inspired servant leaders, as I would call them, we see people who give of themselves and for whom the world doesn't necessarily appreciate their gifts and their wisdom. We see that in people like Martin Luther King Jr., Dorothy Day, Abraham Joshua Heschel, people who were bright lights of service in the name of their traditions, but not necessarily recognized until years after their time on this earth. And I think Gulen and the Hizmet movement give us a glimpse of service and action, active service. I think they contribute greatly to humanity just on a very practical level. Refugee aid, relief for those in need, education. Education is one of the building blocks of life that helps people change their situation, their lives, and I think we see that through the schools in the system. I think that there are people, quite frankly, who just owe their lives to the movement through the medical care they've received or the opportunities they've gotten through their educations. And I think everyone who's involved in the movement and who has an opportunity to contribute in that way, it's a ripple effect of goodness that starts with serving others and then lifts up everyone through that service.
I do think that there's a lot of misunderstanding about Islam and Hizmet. And unfortunately, some of the news we get out of Turkey today, where you hear the Turkish government attacking Hizmet and Gulen, also projects this view that Hizmet is somehow wrapped up in conflict, which is not at all what it's about. So I think it's very hard for someone who is not familiar with the history of Hizmet and the work of Gulen to understand what is happening. There's just a wall of noise that really shouts conflict all the time. This is wrong, this is dangerous. And I think it's going to be necessary for Hizmet to do an even better job of explaining itself, reaching out, introducing people to the work of Gulen. And when you read Gulen's work, it's all about peace, understanding, knowledge, progress. There's very little in it about conflict except how to get past conflict and get over it.
Over and over again, it is, we are not a political movement. We are a social movement seeking to build up humanity. Within some other groups, I do get around to Christian congregations making presentations on Islam. And the usual questions that I will get are, why do they hate us? Why do they want to kill us? And I can say, who? Who is doing this to you? Not the people that I know. And to present Hoca Efendi's views, to present those positions, his quotations, that Islam, you cannot be a Muslim and be a terrorist, this insistence. And that is sincere.
So if you look at Islam, we keep on saying Islam is a religion of peace and submission to the will of God. And peace is something that the Hizmet movement has been, and Fethullah Gulen has been very, very focused on. Peace through love, through harmony. And Islam teaches love. It doesn't teach hatred. In fact, Islam says to kill one life is to kill humanity. And that type of progressive thinking, that type of approach, it's the true approach to Islam. And I think the Hizmet movement and Fethullah Gulen are on that path, the true path to Islam.
Unfortunately, we have a lot of fundamentalists, some of them violent, and the only other voice you tend to hear in the Arab world is a purely traditional one, a moderate one, yes, but traditional. It seems to me, particularly in the Arab world, there's a great need for a modern, progressive, pro-education view of Islam to get the Arab world out of its troubles. So that, to me, they need something very much like the Hizmet movement, and a person like Mr. Gulen, like the Hoca Efendi, who brings science, education, but above all, preaches tolerance. Because to me, tolerance is the mother of all virtues.
Turkish people, they need this movement. And this movement, of course, needs the help of the government. Although the movement is not a political movement, it does not involve in politics, but at the same time, there are many areas the government should not hinder the work of the movement and should be supportive, if not collaborating, but at least support. And at least does not hinder, does not make a create problem. And so there should be, and the movement is a peaceful movement. It's not involved in any violence or anything like that, so this is good. So that's what we have to do. We have to support and encourage peaceful movements in the Muslim world.